and gentlemen, the President of the United States and Mrs. Reagan. Ladies and gentlemen, the national anthem.
Chancellor, this concludes the honors.
Of European peace have been no accident. The good fortune can be traced to a great degree to the solidarity and cooperation between our two peoples and governments. When a buildup of intermediate range missiles by our adversary threatened the peace, our alliance was put to the test. The deployment, however, of weapons is not an end in itself. It is a means to an end. What we seek is the security of our countries, the freedom of our peoples, and the peace of the world. In my recent meetings with General Secretary Gorbachev and subsequent events, there is, as I will explain, ample reason for optimism. Whatever progress is made, it will be based on a solid foundation. German states are now seriously talking about reducing offensive weapons. This is a giant step forward from the time not so long ago. I say when, not if. It will not be the result of weakness or timidity on the part of Western nations. Instead, it will flow from our strength, realism, and unity. Our allies in these last few years are neither vulnerable nor subservient. The record of the European peoples is long and glorious. In so many ways, Europe is the cradle of modern civilization. The indomitable spirit demonstrated on the side of the free. We in the West are now engaged in a great technological revolution in medicine, electronics, physics, and so many fields of human endeavor. More has been discovered, and that protection applies to the United States, our allies, and yes, even our adversaries, if need be. A purely defensive system that makes these missiles ineffective also makes them eliminating the nuclear arsenals that now threaten all humanity. If a defensive system was not a viable option, the Soviet Union would not be committing so much of its own resources in developing and deploying strategic defenses of its own. Technology can open up new doors to peace and security. But we in the West have done to rebuild our strength.
Strive for a free, secure, and prosperous world, a world of peace. And we do it together with our friends and allies, the German people. So it gives me great pleasure to welcome Chancellor
für diesen freundlichen und so warmherzigen Empfang bei Ihnen in Washington. Ich freue mich, dass ich wieder hier sein kann. Und ich denke, dieser wunderbare Herbsttag ist ein Symbol in seinem Sonnenschein.
Fall Day, with its sunshine, is a very true symbol standing for the nature of the relationship between our two countries.
Und ich freue mich, dass
a good friend of our country and an esteemed personal friend.
Es ist das siebente Mal, dass wir uns treffen, seit ich das Amt des Bundeskanzlers 1982 übernahm. Diese Zahl allein lässt die Intensität und die Dichte der Beziehungen unserer beiden Länder und Regierungen erklären. Ich bin ausdrücklich auch hier vor der Öffentlichkeit Ihres Landes für diese vertrauensvolle, enge Zusammenarbeit danken. Es ist Ausdruck einer von gemeinsamen Werten, Idealen und Interessen getragenen Freundschaft und
Partnerschaft. And it is a token of friendship and partnership underpinned by shared values, ideals and interests.
In der Atlantischen Allianz stehen Amerikaner und Deutsche zusammen mit ihren britischen, französischen, italienischen und anderen Freunden.
Freedom and human rights.
Die Sicherheit der Bundesrepublik Deutschland ist auf das engste mit dieser Allianz und mit der Partnerschaft mit den Vereinigten Staaten von Amerika verbunden. Nur der Beitrag. Sie sind uns herzlich willkommen.
American troops
in the Federal Republic of Germany are defending our common freedom together with our troops, and they are welcome in our
manifesto.
Mr. President, you and your fellow citizens in this country should know that the vast majority of the citizens of the Federal Republic of Germany are in favor of the presence of these troops, and they regard them as their friends. We know that we can rely on each other.
Die europäischen Bündnispartner leisten einen wichtigen Beitrag zur gemeinsamen Verteidigung. Die in der europäischen Gemeinschaft zusammengeschlossenen 12 Staaten befinden sich heute in einem dynamischen Prozess politischer und wirtschaftlicher Integration, durch den auch der europäische Pfeiler der Allianz gestärkt wird. Wir Europäer, Präsident, haben erkannt, dass nur auf diese Weise wir gemeinsam eine Rolle in der Welt von morgen spielen können.
The European allies render an important contribution to our common defense, an entity in which we can play a role in tomorrow's world.
Sie, Herr Präsident, haben in den verdammten Reden bei dem Europäischen Parlament in Straßburg die Meinung zu dürfen.
In your speech to the European Parliament in Strasbourg in May 1985, Mr. President, you welcome and appreciate this development. It will not be detrimental to our lives, but it is going to strengthen them.
Unser Ziel bleibt es, unsere Verteidigungsfähigkeit zu gefährden.
It remains our goal, and I know that I shared with you, Mr. President, to create peace and security with ever fewer weapons. In Reykjavik, thanks to your serious and consistent efforts in
wo wirkliche Fortschritte möglich sind.
Your meeting with General Secretary Gorbachev confirmed that the Soviet Union too is interested in an improvement of the relations between West and East, and we should take the Soviet Union at its word and sound out at the negotiating table where real progress could be made.
Meine Regierung, die Welt schaut jetzt hoffnungsvoller, Präsident, auf die beiden Großmächte. Aber auch die mittleren und die kleineren Staaten müssen ihren Beitrag leisten.
My government is contributing actively to the efforts to promote dialogue and cooperation, confidence, understanding and reconciliation. The world is looking hopefully to the two superpowers. But the small and medium-sized states must play their part and make their contributions as well.
Herr Präsident, gemeinsam hieran weiterarbeiten. Wir müssen die junge Generation davon überzeugen, in den USA, wie in der Bundesrepublik Deutschland, wie überall in der Welt, dass es sich lohnt, für unsere Werteordnung, für Freiheit und rechtsstaatliche Demokratie einzutreten.
Mr. President, in your presence together for this goal, we must convince the young people, the young generation in the United States, in the Federal Republic of Germany, all over the world, that it is worthwhile to stand up for our values, for freedom, democracy, and the rule of law between our peoples. For that, I'm grateful to you, and we will discuss this subject further. Together, we shall create conditions under which even more young people from our two countries will have the chance to get to know one another.
Herr Präsident, unter Ihrer Führung haben die Vereinigten Staaten von Amerika Selbstvertrauen und Führungskraft wiedergewonnen. Es sind diese Eigenschaften, die es der großen amerikanischen Nation immer wieder ermöglichen, den Herausforderungen der Zukunft erfolgreich zu begegnen. Wie guter Weggenosse sei.
Mr. President, under your leadership, the United States of America has rediscovered self-confidence and regained the spirit of enterprising leadership. As in the past, these are the qualities that will enable the American nation to master the challenges of the future. The Federal Republic of Germany, with all its citizens, will be a loyal friend and partner to the United States of America as it goes about this task. Thank you very much.
Hold! Hold! Left shoulder! Move!
President. This concludes the ceremony.